Welcome back, students. So let's continue the concluding part of this lesson, Silk Road by Nick Middleton. In the previous video module, we have seen that the narrator and Nobu, that they decided to move ahead together because both were going to do the Kora. That is Kora, a religion, a kind of pilgrimage. The intention was same, the target. So that's why they decided to go together. So later on, the last in the concluding part, the narrator says that my initial relief at meeting Norbu, because he got relief, the sigh of relief there when he met Norbu, because since that time when he had left, or Saturn had left him, the narrator, so from that time he was alone. So from that moment onwards, the narrator was puzzled that what to do or how to move ahead, because he had no idea whether the track is clear or not. So now he met Nobu. My initial relief at meeting Nobu, who was also staying in the guest house, staying in the same place, guest house, was tempered by the realization. Tempered is, what do you mean by tempered? It means weakened. That was also fade away or became fat. Now weakened by the realization that he was almost as ill-equipped as I was for the pilgrimage. Already we know that the narrator was also not well-equipped for the pilgrimage, and he had some hope from Norbu, but now they were staying in the same guest house, and almost his hopes, everything that tempered by the realization that he was also almost as ill-equipped as I was for the pilgrimage. He was also not equipped with the proper things. He kept telling me how fat he was, and Norbu kept telling to the narrator that how fat he was, and how hard it was going to be for Norbu. For what? To do the Kora, to go towards Mount Kailash, because he was fat, very high up, and he kept reminding me, so tiresome to walk, and continuously Norbu, that he kept reminding the narrator that it is so tiresome thing or the job to do or to go towards Mount Kailash. Tiresome is dull and the boring. It is really a very tiresome thing or the task. So tiresome to walk. He wasn't really a practicing Buddhist, who? Norbu. It transpired. But he had enthusiasm, and he was of course a Tibetan. Though he was not a practicing Buddhist, but finally he was a Tibetan, who? Norbu the narrator, he thinks. Now, although I had originally envisaged means here, what thought of or predicted or imagined, to predict, to imagine, to think or thought of. So this is what the meaning of envisaged. Now, although I had originally envisaged making the trek in the company of devout believers. Devout means here pious. This is what the meaning is given here. Devout. D-E-V-O-U-T. It means pious. He had already made up his mind, the narrator, that he would complete the things, or he would making the trek in the company of devout believers there. On reflection, I decided that, and then after thinking that he decided that, the narrator, perhaps Norbu would turn out to be the ideal companion. Instead of getting the company of others, then the narrator decided to get the company of Norbu. It is better to get his company, or he could be the ideal, or he would turn out to be an ideal companion. Who? Norbu. He suggested we hire some yaks to carry our luggage. And then they hired yaks. Yaks means here an ox-like mammal. For what? Why they hired yak? Because to carry out their luggage. which I interpreted as a good sign. The narrator thought it is a good sign, and he had no intention of prostrating himself all round at the mountain. Prostrating means here, what is the meaning of prostrating? It means lying down, stretching and lying down. Stretching and lying down, flat. This is what prostrating, lying down, stretching, lying down. Now, intention of prostrating himself all round and the mount, round the mountain. Not possible, he cried, collapsing across the table in hysterical laughter that he started laughing. It wasn't his style, and anyway, his tummy was too big. Whose? Norwood's. When the narrator, when he expressed his desire, all these things, that time he started laughing, Norwood. And the narrator says that it wasn't his style, and anyway, his tummy was too big. Tummy, stomach. Whose? Nor who's there. So children, in this way, here is the end of the summary or end of this chapter, Silk Road. So far you might have understood Silk Road, it's a kind of track or the path is given, it's a trade path we could say, which connects the two regions, Western to Asia. So all these things here for the Europe we have seen. So now, after this summary or the word to word discussion, in the next video module, we will discuss some important points or the central idea or the theme of this lesson. Thank you.